Hi, you are watching UseWise channel. I'm Adriana Baranek, CEO of Miadria Group. Here with me is Mladen Baranek, your CTO.
Hi.
Today we will be continuing our series on your email server and getting to know it. And today's topic is DMARC. Following on DKIM, and DMARC is also a very important term. Can you tell us more about that, Mladen?
Yes, so till now we discussed MX and SPF and DKIM records. So they can help protect your email from spoofing, but today we are talking about DMARC. It's also DNS record that gives you ability to receive reports from receivers of your emails. So basically, with the DMARC, you can inform receivers of your policy and you can request aggregate and forensic reports. Mm-hmm. So for example, all emails received by Google or Microsoft or Amazon and many other service providers and email servers will respect your DMARC request for submitting aggregate reports, and you will get XML list of all emails received from claiming to be received from your domain. Plus, if those emails do not pass SPF or DKIM checks, then you can immediately get forensic report informing you that someone tried to send unauthorized email in your name. So you can also specify a policy what to do in case of email not passing SPF or DKIM. So you can basically say none, meaning that emails should be delivered, quarantine, meaning that emails should be marked as spam, or reject, meaning that emails should not be delivered to intended recipient. Of course, there are some situations where SPF and DKIM can fail from technical reasons, but email is still valid. And by receiving reports, you can actually analyze and see what is going on with your domain name, and you can protect your brand reputation. You can then move from policy none to policy reject, or immediately say that you would like all the emails that are not verified by SPF or DKIM to be rejected, and then monitor reports and see whether there are any issues with that. So basically, if you are using DMARC, you will not only protect your email users from spam, spoofing and such kind of attacks, but you will also protect receivers of emails from your domain from nasty emails claiming to be from your domain. So it is, of course, not DMARC cannot protect spoofing attacks completely. So if your domain is domain.com and someone sends email from domain.net, that email will still be delivered and will not be protected by DMARC. But then again, at least you protected your domain.com from spoofing attempts.
Yeah, we will be talking more about those issues in following videos. there are so many topics related to your email server that you would not believe it. And we want to be very thorough in those videos, but we want to keep them short and sweet. So I hope that today was that kind of a video. Do we have anything else to add?
Yeah, so basically it is kind of a mandatory to publish a DMARC policy for your domain, and it is expected from reputable brands. Mm-hmm. So please do so, and on useways.com you can check whether actually your domain is using DMARC, SPF and DKIM.
Yes, we will have that service live very soon, and that was it for today. Thank you, Mladen, for your time.
Have a nice day.
Thank you, have a nice day. Bye.